أشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فقد فاز المتقون وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا وإن الله لمع المحسنين. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his divine support, we made it one more week in our struggle to do what is right, in our struggle to do what is right with our life. As a believer, we live every single day not to do what we are told that we are allowed to do by someone, but to do what is right and to do what is truth. Our lesson today, inshallah, will be when you are placed in the valley of making a decision. We have to decide to do what is right. And when you have two choices, and both of them is bitter, we choose which one is right. Though it is bitter. Things have changed. People change. But what a believer can do? With the ayah in the Quran when Allah said, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. If you struggle, those who are struggling in Allah's name, in Allah's way, and for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will give them what they are aiming. And He will guide them towards Allah. And to be guided towards Allah means when you realize that nothing was there on this world worthy of you giving up to. When the yaqeen comes. And yaqeen means the moment when we see everything the way they are. We see the dunya on its real value and the akhirah on its real value. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not change your color because everyone else changed or things have changed. Remain with the color of Islam. Remain with the paint that Allah painted you. Sibghat Allah. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ سِبْغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. The paint of Allah, and whose paint is better and more beautiful than the paint of Allah He put on you. And what is the paint of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Islam. And Islam paints a true Muslim in their belief, the correct and firm one. In their behavior, in their thoughts and ideology, in their action and their words, in everything painted by Islam. So when time changes and people change, what will be the personality of a Muslim? And we will go through 4 points. Point number one, to remember, you will never get might and glory and greatness except through Islam. Al-Izzatu bil-Islam. Remember to remain mighty, and the only way to do so is to go through Islam. Remain a Muslim. Changing and giving it up will make your level worse. Al-Izzatu bil-Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. The reason you change your way of life and give up so many of your values and constants because you think following them, they will give you might, they don't have it. Only Allah is the Almighty and the might will come from Him. And when the hypocrites in the society say and made a decision, لَا إِنْ رَجَعْنَا إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ لَيُخْرِجَنَّ الْأَعَزُّ مِنْهَا الْأَذَلُ. the mighty ones, the strong ones, the great ones will kick out the low and the little and the weak ones. That's what Abdullah bin Ubay said. Together with his team, but Allah's answer was in Surah Al-Munafiqun, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Might belongs to Allah, and Allah will give it to his messenger and give it to the true believers. But the hypocrites, they don't know that reality. وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. They made their conspiracy and plan, and Allah made peace, and Allah will win. So remember to remain strong only with Islam. And if you remember with me, when Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu was going to Bayt al-Maqdis to Palestine to get the keys of the city from them, and on his way there, Abu Ubaidah remarked, and he said to Umar bin Khattab, you are going to have a meeting with great people, great personalities, leaders. Will you change your clothes? There are some patches on Umar's clothes as a Khalifa. It means they are old and worn. And Abu Ubaidah was a bit ashamed. How come our leader like this will meet the leaders of that place who are ornamented with the beauty of this world? Umar bin Khattab said to his companion, Abu Ubaidah, La Ubaidah qalaha ya Abu Ubaidah. Abu Ubaidah, I could not believe someone like you will think that way. You know Islam, and you know that we became mighty with Islam. We became mighty with what is inside us, the way we think and the way we believe. It is not what on us will make us great. It is what is in us will make us great. Nahnu qawmun, and he said this, a voice of might that the true believers will never forget if they know the true meaning of Islam. And these words came from a man. He did not fall from heaven, but he rose from hell. If hell means to live on earth and worship your low desire. Umar was in that life condition. But he accepted Islam and he was out of that. And he said this to them, as a law and a rule to every generation of Islam, نحن قوم أعزنا الله بالإسلام ومهما ابتغينا العزة بغيره أذلنا الله. We are a nation. Allah will raise us and elevate us and give us might and greatness only with Islam. And the sooner we start to think, following those people or that tradition will make us great, Allah will put us down. العزة بالإسلام. Remain great only with Islam. And that is something that we remember. This is our color, and this is our pent. We stay with it. Even if everything else changes in this world, remember to be strong only with Islam. And number two, to remain firm on your values. Al-Thabat ala al-Mabadi. Remain firm and strong and steadfast on your ethics, your values, and your principles. And what that means? As we know, Islam is the way. But the way we live in it, as Mustafa Sadiq al-Rafi said, the example of a human being facing the waves of life is like the example of a ship facing the waves of the ocean. You see the ship sometimes up and sometimes down, sometimes left, sometimes right. It is not the ship doing that, it is the environment. And the ship has no control of that. That is the law of the sea and the wind. But the only law and the choice the ship has is to remain firm and keep your balance and keep going to your target. This is a Muslim in this world. The waves of life may beat you up and down, left and right. That is not you. It is the condition and the circumstance around you. But your law is to remain firm, keep your balance, and keep on going on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And that is the meaning of to remain firm. And you remember with me last time when we said one of the sayings of the wise people, Al-Rujulatu an takuna ma'al haqq wa in lam yatahaqqaq. Real manhood, someone who can claim to be a man or a woman, is someone who will remain with the truth, regardless what. Even if we cannot achieve it, but we know this is the truth, I will stay in it no matter what. Wa an yakuna didd al-batil wa in ghada wa tahaqqaq. And be against the falsehood, even if it wins and overcomes us, we will be against you because you are falsehood. That is the meaning of Tabat, to remain fair. And the poet said, قَالَ لِي صَاحِبِي أَرَاكَ غَرِيبًا بَيْنَ هَذَا الْأَنَامِ دُونَ خَلِيلِ قُلْتُ كَلَّا بَلِ الْأَنَامُ غَرِيبٌ أَنَا فِي عَالَمِي وَهَذِي سَبِيلِي. My friend said to me, I see you strange, rejected, untouchable, not accepted. You have no friends. And I said to my friend, no, I'm not a stranger. This world is a stranger, not me. I live in my world, following my path. And my path is Islam. If everybody else see me as a stranger, that is my nature. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us, the beginning of Islam was like that, minority and weakness. And the end of it will be the same. But good news to those people who don't chant, they remain on it. Even if we lose, we die with the truth. Bada al-Islam ghariban wa sayaudu ghariban fatuba lil-ghuraba. Islam started with weakness, and the Muslims look like strangers in the society, and towards the end it will be the same. One of the new Muslims who had his experience in South Africa, Abdullah Quick, and you know him with his activity, when he said that he heard noise during the night, a parade going on, and when he came out, it was the gay parade, demonstrating their freedom, and that they have to let the world know that they exist and they are here. And they go out like that in big numbers. And this brother came out to find out what is going on. But he came out with his Muslim clothes. And someone came to him with a very strange clothes, chains around the neck, and the hair style very strange, big boots and short baggy pants, and say to him, to this Muslim, you look strange. And the Muslim said, no, you look strange when you look at the reality. But this is our nature. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us, don't change no matter what happened. But some of you will change, he said. لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرًا ذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعًا حَتَّى لَوْ دَخَلُوا جَهْرَ ضَبٍ لَدَخَلْتُمُوهُ. You will follow the way of life of other people, step by step. And you will do everything they do or everything they want, even if they enter the hall of a lesson and they call that the fashion, you will follow him. And it's happening. If they cut their clothes and make it short, we cut our clothes and make it short. And ignore our Quran, our Prophet, our Islamic tradition. If they make it very tight, we make it very tight. The mother, the daughter, the sister, the father, the son. If they go out half naked, we do the same. If they celebrate occasion, we do the same. If they make pictures on the janazah, back to an art, we do the same. And this is the strange thing. It means Islam will not make us great, but those people who will make it. Islam told us, "At-thabat ala al-mabad," remain firm on your values. Trying to be somebody else will never make you better. Number three, no matter what happened, Islam wants us to remain with justice, al-adl. Seek for your mind from Islam, remain firm, and be just and fair. Once we have that, we are Muslims. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his name to himself, Al-Adl, Al-Hakam, just to the extent that he made us aware on the day of judgment. The closest people to us, we live for them and die for them and work hard for them because we are afraid that maybe we have been unfair to them. We run away from them on the day of judgment. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. The day the person will run away hiding from their own brother, their own sister, their own father, mother, son, and daughter. Why? Because being together for so long, sometimes we use that as a sort of abuse. And then we abuse our children, abuse our wife, abuse our husband, abuse our father, our mother, and so on. But on that day, we run away. Because we remember that Allah brought somebody into my life, and every single day, we abuse them. And this is happening more between husbands and wives. Some women just live in the house, but they don't feel like there is a man in their life. There is terrible human in their life. If you cannot keep the oath, free them, don't make them slaves. Because on the day of judgment, as we know, only Allah forgives. No one else will ever forgive us. Not your wife, not your husband, not your son, not your daughter, not your friend, not your enemy, and so on. Only Allah forgives. Because He does not enjoy punishing anyone, but sometimes we go too far. We fight, we don't fight the one who can fight us back. We don't be unjust to the one who can conquer us, but to the one who cannot. And then on that day, the day when we are not willing to forgive those who we love the most, it becomes trouble. And Islam will fail. Not only be just to the people who you love, be just to the people who you don't love. And Allah said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Oh, you who believe, stand up and deal with the world in the name of Allah, using His name. And to use His name only with justice. وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ ala alla ta'adilu. Do not let your hate to people incite you to be unjust to them. It is haram, and once you do that, Allah will become your opponent. And can you imagine someone who is fighting Allah? We will never remember in the history someone who fought Allah and wins a fight. And one way to fight Allah is to be unjust to someone, to your wife, to your husband, to your son, to your daughter. And most of the time, the female side, many daughters are suffering because when it comes to make their life once and for good, who will be the other half of their life? The parents take over and force her into love. And we forget what we call it, love, and force this daughter into hate. But there is a day coming when both will be in the court, and Allah is the judge and the witness, and the ball will be in the corner of the victim. Take whatever you want from the person. So we remember to be just, regardless how unjust somebody in this world could be. And finally, al-itminan wa rida al-nafsi. Remain in your tranquility. Don't panic. Don't be afraid. Because you lean on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say it and believe in it. Hasbi Allah wa ni'ma al-wakil wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyil 'azim. Allah is sufficient for me, and He is the best to rely on. And if we believe in that, we will not panic or become confused or become weak in front of the challenges of life. Poverty cannot disturb our happiness. Death and sickness and anything else that we don't like to face in our life will remain calm. Why? Because of the tranquility of the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alladhina amanu wa tatma'innu qulubuhum bi dhikrillah. Those who believe with reality, their hearts will go into tranquility simply when they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through reading His Quran, or through prayer, or the common zikr that we do. But وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Many people will lead a miserable life. Why? Because they remember everything except Allah. They don't remember Allah when they are earning, or when they are spending, when they are in love or in hate, when they are happy or sad. So they live a miserable life based on happiness or anger or emotion. And that should not be our reference in life. So remain in your tranquility and be content with whatever Allah gives to us. No matter what changes in this world, we remain with the color Allah painted us, and that is the color of Islam. Sibghat Allah, wa man ahsan min Allah sibgha, wa nahnu lahu mukhlisun. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الحكيم وجعلنا وإياكم من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. To summarize, remember that with Islam you will be fine. Remember that, remain strong. There is no room for weakness in facing the works of life. Remember to be just, and remember to remain calm with your iman. And if you have to cry, sometimes you cry. And what to cry mean in Islam? One day the Prophet ﷺ cried. And when he cried, that was the death of some people who went too far. The messenger of mercy, Allah said about him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad, we created you and we sent you out into this world as a source of mercy for everyone and everything. Everyone. But up to some limit, he could not take it, and he told Allah to deal with some people. And he mentioned their names when he said one day, Allahumma alayka bi Abi Jahl ibn Hishar. Oh Allah, deal with Abu Jahl. Allahumma alayka bi Utba ibn Rabi'ah. Allahumma alayka bi Shayba ibn Rabi'ah. Allahumma alayka bi Umayya bin Khalaf. Allahumma alayka bil Walid ibn Utba. Allahumma alayka bi Utba ibn Abi Nu'ayt. These six people, the Prophet's heart had no room for them. And he said what Noah alayhi salam had to say, not to the Ummah, but to those who went too far. And these six people were killed on the battle of Badr and in the well of Badr. They went too far. But no matter what, we have many of them nowadays, but we don't chant, we remain Muslims, because we want to die as Muslims. This dunya and whatever in it is a mirage. And when we are dying, we will see the real picture of this dunya. Allahumma fil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma ahsin khitamana wa akhrijna min ad-dunya muslimin. Allahumma ahsin khitamana wa akhrijna min ad-dunya muslimin. Allahumma antasir lil mustadafina fi kulli makan wa alayka bi tughati adh-dhalimin fa innahum la yu'jizunaka ya hayyu ya qayyum. Allahumma ashfi maradona. اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا واقم الصلاه